We started talking about this project way back in 2009. That's how long ago, and a lot of the freeholders who are there, some who came on, but it's always, they've always been supportive of the project through some very difficult times, and especially led by Chairman Berg. And so for his remarks, Freeholder Chairman Bruce Bergen.
Thank you, Dan. I want to welcome you all to Union County and to our new courthouse. I was not on the Freeholder Board in 2009, but I was here for the last few years to work with the other freeholders and the Improvement Authority to get past the few bumps we had in this project. I want to thank the many honorable officials who are here today, the professional staff and consultants, and everyone who helped bring us to this point. As many of you realize, the construction of this courthouse was a great challenge at times. But as you see today, the effort has produced a beautiful state-of-the-art facility. I want to acknowledge my freeholder colleagues who are here today, Freeholder Estrada, Freeholder Wright, Freeholder Carter, Freeholder Hudak, Freeholder Mirabella, and Vice Chairman Granados, and thank them as well for their support of this project as we went along. With us today also are many of our department heads, County Manager Al Fiella, and our Deputy County Manager Amy Wagner, both of which have helped move this project forward. And of course, I do want to thank again the Union County Improvement Authority, their members, their staff, and professionals for everything they did to move this project along. And I do have to acknowledge as well the City of Elizabeth and Mayor Bowish, as well as council members and Board of Education members who are here today as well. I want to extend a warm welcome to the members and leaders of the Union County Bar Association, as well as all of the judges and other staff from the courts, and of course to Chief Justice Rabner and his staff as well. Welcome, and thank you for joining us. I also need to welcome our prosecutor, Grace Park, and First Assistant Prosecutor Tim Eisenhower, who have worked with us to help put together the way this building will function, and I'll get back to that in a little bit. We're here to dedicate this building because we care about helping our youth and families in this county. Martin Luther King once said, "Human progress is neither automatic nor inevitable. Every step towards the goal of justice requires sacrifice, suffering, and struggle. The tireless exertions and passionate concern of dedicated individuals." Those dedicated individuals are the people who will work in this courthouse day in and day out, seeking justice for our citizens. I want to take a moment to share a couple of the details about this building. This new courthouse provides over 78,000 square feet of new space. And as I mentioned before, it will house the newly established Union County Family Justice Center, which is expected to open sometime towards the end of this summer. The FJC will provide victims of domestic violence with legal assistance, crisis counseling, court advocacy, logistical support, and housing aid, making the manner in which domestic violence cases are handled fully holistic in nature. This building was designed in accordance with New Jersey Courthouse Facility Guidelines and embraces the latest in technology and security features to serve judges, staff, lawyers, and litigants. It includes four interconnected systems, each separate and secure, including six state-of-the-art courtrooms and support facilities, judges' chambers and support staff offices, prisoner intake, holding, and attorney-client conference space, and the Sheriff's Department security control facilities. For those of you who would like to get a closer look at the building, we're offering tours once we've completed this dedication ceremony. Having practiced law for more than 35 years, with much of it in this courthouse complex, I am very pleased to have been part, albeit in a small way, in bringing this project to a successful conclusion. Once again, thank you all for joining us today.
Thank you, Chairman Bergen. And now it is a privilege for me to introduce Union County Assignment Judge Karen Cassidy for the introduction of the Chief Justice.
I just need to start off, before I do my introduction, with a few thank yous of my own. Obviously, just by the sheer scope of this project, this was an enormous undertaking. And a facility of this magnitude does not happen but for the efforts of many, many individuals. When you were saying 2009 was when this began, I became the assignment judge in 2009, so this is somewhat my legacy at the moment. I'm not sure if it's a good legacy or not, given how long it's taken, but I'm so, so proud of all of the efforts that went into this. During that time, I've had to put on a hard hat and walk this building. Who knew I had the capacity to be almost like a general contractor, but we had construction design meetings. We needed to consider needs of the bench, the bar, the public. And we did really have a cooperative partnership among so many. And as you can tell, the results we've achieved are amazing. I want to thank all of our county freeholders. Some of them I've had the opportunity to present different things to as this project was moving forward. The County Improvement Authority, who again we worked with diligently, Mast Construction, Net of the Architects, Perini, who finally took this building over and got it to where it is today. The various stakeholders that are in this county that we worked with, we have meetings, you don't even want to know how many meetings we have, but an abundance of them. But we had all of the people I've just mentioned, along with the Sheriff's Department, facilities people, council for the county, for their input and participation, and we couldn't have pulled this together without all of them. I also want to thank the director, Judge Grant, and the Chief Justice for coming here today and being a part of this ceremony. I think it really says a lot to everyone here that you would be honored, or we would be honored with your presence at the ribbon cutting of this facility. Finally, I want to thank not only the dignitaries that I missed, but the members of the bar. The Union County Bar Association, who I hope will utilize all of the wonderful meeting space that we now have and other spaces that are designed to facilitate your interaction with your clients and the court system. Some of them will remember, and some of our judges will remember, because I'm going to get to you in a second, a very, very cold day. It was February. There was no heat. This building was somewhat of a shell. And it might have, I don't know if it was this courtroom or another one, but we were trying to figure out where we needed to put the bench, how big the bench was going to be, how high it was going to be, where the and we're doing this in sub-zero temperatures. I had my Uggs on, I had scarves, it was incredible. And we had members of the Bar Association with us because we recognized that we needed them. They were gonna be using these courtrooms to be a part of the experience, and what an experience it was on that particular day. So my last thank you goes out to the judges and staff at the courthouse and also at the administrative office of the courts for their tireless efforts in making this whole project happen. From participating in design concepts, and we were walking around today and looking at how all the color schemes came together. I didn't know I was going to also be an interior designer when I started this job. To making sure that our judges' needs, as well as their staff, their secretaries and law clerks' needs were met. To arranging financing for all of the furnishings that go into this building and putting together all of the other systems, IT, our recording system, which is CourtSmart. A lot of things go into putting this building together. So we joined with all of those entities I mentioned that were constructing the building so that problems and concerns were addressed expeditiously and dealt with the day-to-day issues that go into the construction of such a comprehensive new facility. As a judiciary, we are so proud of this courthouse for so, so many reasons. This is the first time that litigants are able to come to one facility that will address their needs in one location. Not that we don't appreciate what we work with each and every day, but those of you who are practicing attorneys know that when you went to file something in the family division, you'd go to counter A, And then when you had to meet with your probation officer to intake the case, you might go across a hall, you might go to another building. And then when the case was ready and you needed to go to a courtroom, that might be in yet another building. And it was a maze for the litigants to have to go through, despite the fact that we worked through that. Well, now, it's kind of a one-stop shopping for much of that. Here, the public is going to file their documents. Directed right behind them will be the staff that can interview them so their matters can be listed for a hearing if that's appropriate. The victims of domestic violence are going to have waiting rooms that are adjacent to the courtrooms. Not down the hall, not up the stairs, not looking for sheriffs to get them. They're going to be right there in a locked, safe facility so that they'll be able to be in a place that's easily accessible for them and for the judges once their cases are ready to be heard. Attorneys and clients hopefully will not be meeting in stairwells anymore, which a lot of times would happen. There are a lot of meeting rooms here, and we also have secure meeting areas for those who are inmates to meet with their attorneys right here and be able to talk with them in those secure interview rooms. Parents who do not have an ability to secure care for their children will have a staffed, safe, and well-appointed waiting area available. I can't tell you how many times when I sat in the family division and my judges who sit in family right now and in special civil and in sometimes even in criminal have a toddler on their lap while they're trying to proceed with a case. And we as judges would, you know, sometimes try and grab a probation officer or law clerks, especially if the testimony was something you didn't want to have your children hear. And I'm so grateful that the county has come forward with providing us with some staff to get that up and running. And that will also be utilized by the Family Justice Center as well, so that those children can be in an inviting environment with activities and things while their parents are dealing with issues that they shouldn't have to listen to. I know I went on a little bit long, but I really thought it was important that I tried to give you an understanding of how wonderful this place is, how happy we are to have it, and how grateful we are for all of you who put this together for us. And I can't say thank you enough, so I really appreciate that. Now I'd like to turn to a brief introduction of someone who probably doesn't need much of an introduction, but I do have a few things I just want to say about our Chief Justice, the Honorable Stuart Rabner. He has been our chief since he was appointed to that position in 2007. He was nominated for tenure by Governor Christie. Originally, he was appointed by Governor Corzine and received tenure in 2014. You'll see his biography in your program, so I'm not going to go into all of those details. But I just would like to say that the tenure of him as a Chief Justice has been marked by his dedication to improving our justice system through a number of initiatives. He's tackled a lot of issues that are before the citizens of our state, such as dealing with increased foreclosure filings and providing for a foreclosure mediation program, protection of our vulnerable citizens through a guardianship monitoring program, and finally, the most recent overhaul of our criminal justice system through bail reform and speedy trial enactments. So I have the pleasure of working with the chief each and every month when I meet with judicial counsel, and maybe even more than that in phone calls and other things that we need to deal with issues that crop either in our small vicinage here in Union County or statewide. And it has been my pleasure to work with him over the past 8 years. So I'd like to now introduce and call up here our Chief Justice, Stuart Rabner.
Thank you, Judge Cassidy, Judge Grant, fellow judges, Senator Scutari, Chairman Bergen, Sheriff Cryan, Prosecutor Park, Mayor Bolwage, Mr. Sullivan, and I apologize to those names that I should have but didn't yet acknowledge. It is a delight to be here with colleagues and friends and members of the bar alike. Not only am I delighted to be here to help celebrate the opening of this courthouse, but it is worth pointing out again and again, and you've heard it a few times, Assemblyman Quijano, welcome. It is worth pointing out what a remarkable project this is and the remarkable statement it makes. But first I want to put you all at ease a little bit, because I got a bootleg copy of the agenda, the program for today on Friday, and I saw how many people were listed as speakers before me, and that I was listed as the keynote speaker. So to make sure that I got off on the right foot, I grabbed Webster's Dictionary to look up keynote. And there's a definition at the very end that you may not have yet seen that says, if you follow an illustrious group, a large number of speakers, keynote means be brief. And I'm going to do my best to live up to that, because the follow-up definition is, if refreshments follow, be even more brief. So let me get to the heart of the matter, because I believe this new courthouse facility will enhance our system of justice here in this community in any number of ways, and I want to speak about two of them. The first is a very practical point. As the judges well know, and as so many of us in this room know, the decisions that are made in family court are among the most important and sensitive that take place in any courthouse throughout the state. These decisions literally shape the lives of families. They affect the relationship of spouses, of parent and child. They have a lasting effect on families in ways that we can't even predict at the time that they are made. They also change the path of misguided youth. They respond to allegations of domestic violence. They speak to families in crisis, all with enormous consequences, each and every one. And with the completion of this project, you've heard about some of the thoughtful ways in which this space was designed. We not only have 6 courtrooms, but as Judge Cassidy just went through, space for children, space for victims of domestic violence to have a place in a moment of solace before the proceeding begins, space for lawyers and family members whom they represent to be able to speak in private about private matters. We should all be quite proud. You should all be extremely proud of what you have done in that regard, this construction of the physical space. And that brings me to the second point, and that is the broader statement that this project makes about how important a system of justice is to this community. In times like these, governments look for ways to do more with less. They look for ways to save taxpayer dollars, and it is by no means easy to find the resources to build a grand project such as this one. But the political leaders of this community, the members of the public, recognized the importance, the overriding value of this effort, the importance that a new courthouse facility has, that it is more than just physical space that is so sorely needed. It is a symbol of our democracy and how vital the system of justice is in this community, in this state, in this nation. You know, in the years to come, there will be any number of high-profile cases that are going to be heard in front of the judges in this facility. And it's going to garner the attention of the public, of the press. We'll be reading about it. We'll be talking about it. But I want to suggest to you that what will take place here in this building each and every day is even more important than those high-profile matters will be. Because the people that walk into this building, our friends, our neighbors, come here because they believe they've been wronged and they're looking to vindicate their rights. And what they're hoping for is a fair shake, is a fair hearing as we look at matters that will affect them in profound ways. And they're going to appear in front of judges. You know, I used to try cases, and as I look at this august body of jurors that sits in a juror box, I was thinking a moment ago, would I want them as a jury? Because, you know, the lawyers here realize that no matter how many questions they're permitted to have answered, you never know enough about the jury, and you try to draw conclusions out of, you know, the way a person looks at you and the sober feeling that you're getting from this jury box here today. I will tell you, I would like to try a case in front of this jury because they are people who believe in the rule of law, and they are people of integrity who our citizens will be fortunate to come before, and they'll be able to fulfill their obligations working alongside staff in this wonderful new facility. For all the people that will set foot in this courthouse, judges, staff, lawyers, litigants, everyone here will know that this is a place where we can count on the bar being set high and the highest of standards being lived up to each and every day. This is a place where justice will be administered in Union County for years to come. And on behalf of the public, the bar, the entire judiciary, I want to again thank our political and public leaders and officials for their vision, for their stick-to-itiveness to make sure that they nurtured this project over the years, and for their leadership. Thank you all very, very much. Congratulations.
Our thanks to both Judge Cassidy and Judge Rabner for their remarks. We are now going to proceed with the ribbon cutting. So I'm going to ask the officials to come forward.
One, two.